What's a shaking in the movies? Let's go to Russ and Sean.
Well, let's find out. Welcome to the screening room. I'm Russ Simmons.
And I'm Sean Edwards. Yeah, no earthquake here, but we do have a few movies to talk about. We're going to start first with what?
It's called Blinded by the Light. It's a comic drama, and it feels a little sentimental and warmed over. But you know what, Sean? The infectious goodwill of this true story may well break down your resistance.
Or maybe not.
Well, in 1987, the life of a teen Pakistani Brit changes forever when he discovers the music of Bruce Springsteen.
The Boss.
Yes, listening to The Boss inspires him to become a writer and faces considerable challenges head on.
Yeah, it's cute. A little bit tedious and also generic, but Russ, the characters are likable and the story connects at sort of a surface level.
You don't have to be a Springsteen fan to enjoy it, but it helps.
Yeah, Blinded by the Light works pretty much in the same way Yesterday worked for Beatles fans. There's just no way, though, the movie can live up to the nostalgic value of the music, but it's still a good watch.
Three popcorn bags for me.
I agree, three popcorn bags.
Well, if you're unfamiliar with Angry Birds, you may still be using a rotary dial phone. The loopy humor and frenetic action of this animated sequel, Angry Birds Movie 2, they're clearly designed for the younger movie-going demographic.
Yeah, Angry Birds 2 is actually a lot of fun for us, and it's better than the original. I really like the over-the-top energy, and the fact that it's silly for the sake of being silly was sort of refreshing.
Yeah, it's harmless, well-animated, it may not soar, but it's no turkey.
Yeah, kids will definitely enjoy, and there's enough to keep adults entertained.
Three popcorn bags for me.
I'm right there with you, three popcorn bags.
Now, if your idea of cinematic hilarity is hearing three sixth-grade boys cuss like sailors and chatter on about sex and drugs, boy, have I got a movie for you.
Mark Offit's already in line.
Good Boys is like a preteen Superbad, a raunchy R-rated movie with stars so young they aren't even allowed in to see it.
That's very true, but first things first, Russ. Seth Rogen isn't in the movie. He just produced it. Secondly, it's very funny. Thirdly, it's also super raunchy.
Yeah, Jacob Tremblay, Keith L. Williams, and Brady Noon play these close pals who make some bad decisions that sets his farce into motion.
Yeah, they have great chemistry together. And Russ, here's the deal. It's nothing you haven't seen before unless you're 16 years of age or under, and that's debatable. But the jokes are delivered with the freshness and cuteness that makes them work on a new level.
Well, the three lads are appealing, and the movie, I admit, has some funny moments, but most of these risque elements seem very forced to me. It's got a good-natured vibe, though, that almost redeems it. Almost.
Yeah, yeah, all these comedies have jokes that are forced. I mean, you know, here's the deal. This is the funniest movie so far this year, and the shock value of the gags is money. Therefore, Good Boys is very good.
I'll give it three popcorn bags.
I'm going four popcorn bags for Good Boys. I actually liked it because the kids played younger, which made this sort of different.
You can see all of our reviews and interviews with Hollywood's biggest stars at fox4kc.com/screeningroom.
Check out our Facebook page or watch us on YouTube, and that's a look at the movies hitting the box office.
Hey, by the way, on our Facebook page right now, we're giving away two different movie passes. So if you check it out on our Facebook page.
You got to go to the Facebook page to find out.
Well.
And, hey, Mark, we want to give a big shout out to Morgan Cooper. He's screening his new film at the Screenland Armor this Saturday.
Really?
And it's a fundraiser for the... for an arts foundation.
And which movie is that?
For Pat Jordan's Art Foundation. He wouldn't tell me. It's a surprise.
Ah.
He just said it's Screenland Armor on Saturday, and he's going to be talking about his trailer Bel Air tonight at the 816 Film Festival.
Very cool.
Yeah. He's doing, a lot going on.
He just told me in my ear, like, he's doing big things, and he's excited to tell the people about, but they have a strategic plan to unveil all of that.
Okay. Mm.
Featuring our own Mark Offit.
Yeah, I'm excited.
It's not featured. I had a little cameo.
We're going with featured, man.
Just own it.
Yes. You look like the Dos Equis man in the trailer.
Although yeah. I did look pretty darn good.
Yeah.
A goatee.